Good day, ma'am. I am Arvin Mar A. Magdadaro, and the one of the reporter of Group 3, and I am here to discuss or explain the given topic, which is the material aspect of self. According to William James, it is materialism is variable relevant to many aspects of economic psychology. A discussion of the potential relationship between materialism and several economics variables, including use of money, work motivation, giving, and materialism. The use of economic goods in social communication and the potential role of materialism in such communication. James described two aspects of the self that he termed the I-self and the me-self. The I-self reflects what people see or perceive themselves doing in the physical world. Example, recognizing that one is working, eating, writing, whereas the me-self is more subjective and psychological phenomenon. So, what is the I-self? I-self refers to the self that know who she or he is, while the me-self refers to describing the person's experiences and further divided into subcategories, which are material self, social self, and spiritual self. So, we are living in a world of sale and shopping spree. We are given a wide array of products to purchase, including the digital space. We can find promotion of product purchase. Product advertisements are suggestive of making us better or look good. Parts of us wants to have a product are connected with who we are, what we want to have and already possess. So here's my explanation based on my own understanding. Material self is the material needs of everybody. Based on my own understanding about this statement, things can show or reflect ourselves of what we want and who we are. The best example for that is clothing. In the self, there is body, and we need clothes in order to dress and to have fashion for us to make better, presentable, or look good, not just self-saying but also in the eye of other people. It reflects who we are. Why? The explanation for that is, it's because if we wear a better clothes or dress, a clean one, it reflects the inner of ourselves that we are clean or a good person. Kumbaga, ikaw ay malinis sa iyong sarili or sa anumang bagay. So that's why things reflects of what ourselves. Other example for material self is you're in situation in a place that you want to choose between two things. Just like, for example, the t-shirt. You like the style or the appearance of the both t-shirt, and its differences only is the color, which is the black and white color and the pure white color. And you're going to choose one. For me, I'm going to choose the black and white color. It's just because it reflects myself that I have a good personality or attitude, at the same time, the bad one. The good personality or attitude describe the white color of the t-shirt, and the bad one describe the black part color of the t-shirt. That's how things can reflect ourselves of who we are. The three components of the empirical self. William James used the term the empirical self to refer to all the various ways people answer the question, who am I? And there is three constituents, which are the feelings, emotions, and actions. So, we're talking about the three constituents. First, emotions. Emotions are associated with bodily reaction that are activated through neurotransmitters and hormones released by the brain. And the second one is feeling. Feelings are the conscious experiments of emotional reactions. Kumbaga, the feelings depend of how emotional you are. The third one is the action. it is the bodily movement also answer the question, who am I? So that's all about my explanation, and let's welcome to the next reporters, Miss Geraldine Mahasol from Group 3, for continuing the explanation about the given topic, which is the material aspect of self.
Let's talk about the constituents of the self. The first one is material self, second is social self, third is spiritual self, and the last one is the pure ego. So according to William James, he defined material self as certain to the object, places, or events, people which have the level mind. Such possessions are viewed as extensions of individuals' identities. Like for instance, your clothes. So your clothes reflect certain aspect of your personality, and you designate them as my wardrobe. So next is the social self. So social self is a multifaceted self based on the social nature of the self. So the emphasis is on self-esteem along with self-centrality, self-complexity, social interest, identification, power, marginality, openness, and majority identification. So now let's talk about the spiritual self. So spiritual self, it comes from Buddhism, Hinduism, and psychology is the self as differentiated from your sub-personalities, feelings, and body image. So lastly is the pure ego. So James identified such thought as belonging to the pure ego, a wholly subjected phenomenon, and suggested that its perceptions of continuing personal identity arise from the continuity of the stream of consciousness, resemblance among the part of the continuum of feelings, especially bodily feelings. So material self has its compositions. These are the body, clothes, and immediate family. So body is the innermost part of our material self. So intentionally, we invest in our body because we are directly attached to this community that we cannot live without. So we strive hard to make sure that this body functions well and good, because as much as possible, kita tanan dili ganahan magkasakit, kay kita ragihapon ang maglisod. So we invest. So according to Hermann Lotze, anytime we bring an object into the surface of our body, we invest that object into the consciousness of our personality, a personal existence, taking in its contours to be our own and making it part of the self. So the fabric and the style of the clothes we wear bring sensation to the body, of which directly affect our attitude and behavior. So clothing is a form of self-expression because we choose and wear clothes what reflect to ourselves. The next one is we have an immediate family. So these people are likely to shape and influence the development of self-identity. And this includes our parents, siblings, and other family member, we view them as part of ourselves. But when we talk about material self, so basically, we talk about our positions. And based on that, ang ingon kay we are what we have. So, according to Russell book, we regard our positions as part of ourself. We are what we have and what we possessed. Kung unsay naa sa atoa, it can describe who we are, what our priorities and wants. Do we want those branded clothes or thief clothes? So it describes our personality. So when we are what we have, it is simply says that characteristic things, attitude and positions that we have reflect to ourselves. It's described to us as a person. Like, for instance, if you like cute dogs, teddy bears and any cute toys, it means it describe you a person like cute things, or describe you as a cheerful and girly. So as we grow older, we putting importance to material possession decreases. However, material possessions gains higher value in our lifetime if we use material possessions to find happiness. So, associate these things with significant events. So, accomplishments and people in our lives, there are even times when material possession of a person that is closely identified to the person against acknowledgement with high regard, even if the person already passed away. So, the possessions that we dearly have tell something about who we are, our self-concept, our past, and even our future. So, even our future. So, that's all for our topic. Thank you for listening. Once again, we are from Group 3 reporting the material aspect of self.